off. What happened? You all seem to be so happy today. What's the good news?
We got A grade.
Congratulations. This calls for a celebration then. Where are my sweets? I think you have not got it for me. It's okay. I have a surprise for you all. You all love surprises, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. You want to see what it is?
Yes, ma'am.
Let's go and see. Come. Come, kids. I have a surprise for you all today. Which one would you like to have? Chocolates or honey?
Chocolates, ma'am, because I like chocolates the most.
Okay. What about you?
I also like chocolate.
Not honey? Anyone?
No.
Okay.
I
so
like
will
honey.
You like honey?
Yes.
Okay.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Welcome.
Thank you, ma'am.
Welcome.
Thank you, ma'am.
Welcome. I would prefer to have honey.
Ma'am? Why do you like honey?
Because chocolates causes tooth decay, whereas honey helps to improve your health.
Yes, ma'am.
Purva, you seem to be asking some question to me.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, tell me.
Honey and toffee are sweet, but how will honey improve my health?
Great. This is what I was waiting for. See, kids, learn from Purva. This is how you should be asking questions like what, who, how. This will help in improving your knowledge and thinking skills. Coming back to your question, dear. Honey is natural and has a lot of vitamins. It helps you to improve your immunity and fight against diseases. So, once in 2 to 3 days, you must have 1 spoon of honey to improve your health. Now, let me ask you, all the products which we get in the market, are they pure or not?
No, ma'am.
Exactly. Some of them are not pure. Those are called adulterated food.
Ma'am, what is adulteration?
Very good, Purva. This is how you should be asking question. Let us all clap for Purva. Okay, Purva, can you now repeat your question?
Ma'am, what is adulteration?
Adulteration is addition or subtraction of similar looking, cheap and low quality substance to food material to increase weight.
Cooking oil like groundnut oil or olive oil is adulterated with palm oil. Red chili powder adulterated with food color to make chili powder look crimson red. High quality turmeric powder is adulterated with low quality turmeric powder. Ghee is adulterated with vanaspati.
Ma'am, will we fall sick if we eat adulterated food?
Of course, we will fall sick if we eat adulterated food. Now, kids, let us perform an experiment to find whether honey is adulterated or not. Okay, kids?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, let's go. Parents and my fellow teachers can help the children to perform the experiment and guide them through the activities to draw conclusion. Okay, kids, I hope all of you have got your notebooks and pen today?
Yes, ma'am.
Very good. So today we are going to do something very interesting. We are going to perform an experiment and I want you all to observe it carefully. Okay?
Okay, yes, ma'am.
Okay. So let us begin by drawing a table and drawing out our conclusions to it. Now, you can also draw the table being displayed on the screen and draw your conclusions. So kids, let us begin by drawing the table.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, let's start. So she is ready with her table. Watch the experiment carefully and write down your observations in the column provided as tick or cross. So first, we are going to start with the experiment called dissolving test. Now let us see the materials required for the experiment. we have two samples of honey. This is sample 1 labeled as 1. This is sample 2 labeled as 2. Then we have taken two beakers half filled with water, each labeled as A, and the other beaker is labeled as B. For this experiment, we also require 2 tablespoons. So now we begin with the experiment. First, we are going to take the honey sample 1. Take the tablespoon. Now, take half a tablespoon of honey sample 1 and pour it into the beaker labeled A. Carefully observe the beaker when the honey is being poured into it. Here I pour the honey sample 1. Here we see the honey goes in the form of the string and settles down at the bottom of beaker A. Isn't this wonderful? Yes, kids. Very good. Now, let us see what happens when we add honey sample 2 into the other beaker. Take the other spoon. Take the honey sample 2. Carefully pour it into the beaker B. Observe it carefully. Here it goes. So kids, now let us see what all you have observed. Okay? So here I have beaker A. Look carefully. Do you see the honey here?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, tell me, Surbhi, what do you see here?
Ma'am, I see that the honey came like a string and it is settled down in the water.
Okay, so do you see the water to be clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Exactly, the water is clear here, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so let us write down the observation now.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay, children, so all of you have written down your observations?
Yes, ma'am.
Very good. So let us see what happened in the next beaker. So here we have the beaker B. Observe it carefully. What do you see here? Is the water clear?
No, ma'am.
No. Okay. And did the honey settle down at the bottom?
No, ma'am.
Okay. So now let us write the observation with beaker B. Write down in your notebooks. Okay, kids, moving on to the next experiment, that is the blotting paper test. For this experiment, the materials required are, first we have the honey sample labeled as 1. Next we have the honey sample labeled as 2. Next, we take two blotting papers, blotting paper A and blotting paper B. Now, we begin the experiment. All of you carefully observe the experiment. First, we take the honey sample 1 and the blotting paper A. Pour a few drops of honey over it. Now, fold the blotting paper into half. Press lightly like this and keep this aside. Now take the blotting paper B. Similarly, take a small amount of honey from sample 2. Pour a few drops of it over the blotting paper B and fold it into half. Press lightly and keep it aside. Now, make your observations. After some time, open the blotting paper A. Here at the portion, we see there are no wet marks. And what do you observe? Do you observe anything on the other side of the blotting paper?
No.
No, right? Okay. Now, let us see what has happened with blotting paper B. Here we observe. What do you observe now?
I can observe that the sheet is wet from backside.
Very good, Surbhi. Let us all clap for her. Excellent. The blotting paper B is wet on the other side, whereas in A, it is not. So, let us write down these observations in the table. Okay, very good. Let us write it down. Very good. So, everyone wrote down their observations?
Yes, ma'am.
Very good. Now, moving on to the next experiment, the thumbnail test. So, for this test, we would require honey sample 1, labeled as 1. Next one, honey sample 2, labeled as 2. And a paper. For this experiment, first of all, you have to take a very small amount of honey sample 1. Pour a few drops onto your left thumbnail. Similarly, take the other honey. Here goes a few drops of honey sample 2 onto your right thumb. Now, kids, tilt your thumbnails and observe how the honey drips off from the two thumbnails. So, what do you see, kids? From the thumbnail, that the left thumbnail has the honey which drops off very slowly. Whereas in the right thumbnail, we have the honey sample which drips off very quickly. So, now let us write our observations in the notebook. So now, kids, let us try to find out the reasons behind our observations. The very first test was the dissolving test. So, the pure honey in this sinks to the bottom of the beaker and the water remains clear. Whereas, the adulterated honey dissolves in the water and the water turns cloudy. So, kids, now tell me, which among the two samples was pure and which one was adulterated? Tell me about first honey sample 1. Is this pure or adulterated?
It's pure.
Very good. Now sample 2. Whether this is pure or adulterated?
Adulterated.
Very good. Let's clap for ourselves. So write this down in your observations. Now, you all can also write down which among the two samples was pure and which one was adulterated. We have seen that the pure honey did not leave any wet mark on the blotting paper, whereas the adulterated honey left a wet mark on the blotting paper. Now, kids, tell me which one is the pure honey and which one is the adulterated honey. What about the sample number 1? Is it pure or adulterated?
Sample number 1 is the pure honey.
Very good, Surbhi. Moving on to the honey sample 2. What do you think? This is pure or adulterated?
Sample number 2 is adulterated honey.
Very good, Purva. That's exactly the right answer. Now, let us try to know the reason behind this. This was because honey sample 1 is the pure honey. This contains a very little amount of water. Whereas, the adulterated honey contains more amount of water. P pure honey does not contain any sugar or jaggery syrup in it, which makes it more thicker. Whereas our adulterated honey contains jaggery or sugar syrup, which makes it less thicker. I hope all of you also understood the reason behind this experiment.
Wow, miss, how do you know so much about honey?
This is my secret.
Miss, no secrets between us. Please tell us your secret. We will not tell anyone. Promise.
Promise.
Okay. Exactly. No secret should be there between us. So now I let the cat out of the bag. So the secret is, I am into rearing of honeybees.
Miss, tell us more,
please.
Okay. I'll tell you more about it. This is my village, Buchaha, in Muzaffarpur district, Bihar. My name is Anita. Welcome to my sweet home. My family is small. I live with my parents and two young brothers.
Our sheep are kept in pen in night.
Meet my uncle. He is an expert in weaving bamboo baskets. These are the elders of the village, gathered at Chopal. The elders sort out the village issues sitting here.
My father is shepherd. As I was helping my parents in grazing the sheep, my parents did not want me to go to school.
This is my school. I love my school. I was unhappy as I could not go to school, play with my friends, share midday meal, play and fight, and make friends again. It's pretty cool to go to school, isn't it? One of my cousin brother is bullying type. He never allowed me to play with them. I don't like him. My class teacher thankfully talked to my parents about girl education and right to education.
Right to Education Act 2009. RTE provides the right of free and compulsory education to each child aged 6 to 14 years. I promised my father that I will be helping him in grazing sheep in my holidays as I love my flock of sheep.
I kept my promise and helped my father and mother in household work during my holidays. Going to school, I started teaching smaller kids and saved little money that I earned. As under Right to Education Act, I got uniform, shoes, books, and bag. I started going to school by bicycle, presented by the government. Years passed by.
I came to know about rearing of honeybees while reading newspaper.
I was somehow interested in honeybees. I even applied, got selected, and completed my training successfully. Do you know that reading newspaper is an exceptionally good habit? So does anyone of you read newspaper in your home? I suppose nobody reads a newspaper at their home. It's okay. It's better late than never. So from today onwards, we all promise that every day, you all have to read the newspaper and bring to the school one news from it. Will you promise me that you would do that?
Yes, ma'am.
Very good. Every one of you are also requested that every day you would read the newspaper which you get at your house and bring one news clipping from it and read it out in your classroom. Now we shall move back to our little secrets.
Apiculture or beekeeping is the maintenance of bee colonies in man-made hive by humans.
I got 2 honeybee boxes with the money I saved and started apiculture. By selling honey, I could help improve my family earnings. My daddy was very happy. I also took care that some honey is left for the small babies of the honeybees. That way I can continue beekeeping. I helped others in the village to rear honeybees. In my village, more people are into honeybee rearing. Now we all collectively do honeybee rearing, discuss and solve our problems. You know, teamwork is always giving the best results. So it brought for us as well. While grazing goats and while going to the school, I used to enjoy plucking flowers, suckled for sweet nectar. I miss all the childhood fun. So kids, have you ever plucked a flower and sipped it?
Yes, miss.
My area has many lychee trees. Honeybees are attracted to flowers of lychee, pomegranate, apple, guava, banana, citrus, and many more fruits and vegetable plants. Many people do beekeeping and sell honey. I was somehow interested in honeybees.
Okay, Purva, what was the taste of it?
It tastes sweet.
This is called nectar. So kids, we shall explore more about the home of honeybees, that is the honeycomb or hive and honey tomorrow. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
So here, we are going to explore more about honeybees and about their homes in the next class. Thank you. So kids, today we learnt that
Anita loves her sheep and is also interested in studies.
Anita kept her promise she made to her parents. Honey is produced by honeybees. We know that honey is natural. It also can be adulterated. Now, at home, explore the flowers that have nectar and draw pictures and also write their names. Take the help of your elders. Locate Muzaffarpur in India map and find what is it famous for. Next, write down 5 sentences on Anita's childhood. Right to education. Adulterated food.
Children, let us try to match some more animals with their homes. Make 2 columns in your notebook and list out the animal name in first column and their homes in second column as displayed on the screen. No need of drawing pictures. Your answer. Good job. Thank you. Wear mask. Stay safe. Thank you.
Thank you.